Rise Against had 15 years of number one tracks to play Friday night at Sonic Boom. But for these Chicago punk rockers, it has never been about breaking records or climbing music charts.
We're in Walt Disney World, yay! And we're with all of our favorite characters and so happy to be here.
What is wrong with us? On Friday, we both said, without a doubt, it's a no-brainer, Hangover 3, first place
I don't
spot.
Think there's anything wrong with us. I think we just have no idea what we're talking about.
Yeah, just with this, though. With everything else, we absolutely know what we're talking about. There are a number that start tonight or first thing tomorrow morning, but wrap up by the end of the weekend. We'll check those out next.
You either have no idea or you're silly not going to divulge with me right now.
Yeah, to be honest with you, it's the former. Hard.
Last night, our city's most talented artists were all under one roof to not only show off their skills, but to receive some serious recognition.
Oh my gosh! Yes! Yes! Oh my God.
When I say the words Florida-Georgia line, I doubt that you're thinking of the border that separates the two southern states. That's because the two hitmakers behind that name are taking over the country music world. And last night, they cruised through Rexall for thousands of screaming fans.
Most musicians have to put out a couple albums before they experience what being on top feels like, but not Florida-Georgia Line. Their debut single, Cruise, shot to number one, went platinum six times, and even broke the record for longest number one single on Billboard's Hot Country Songs chart.
We couldn't wait for the world to hear it the day we got it back. It was just incredible. We listened to it about 100 times and felt like it was going to be big. We just feel very blessed to be a part of a cool song, cool movement, to see our fans just assemble like an army around us.
And they assembled a faithful following. All five singles off their debut record hit that coveted number one spot.
Our album, Here's the Good Times, is our life put to music. We know that our fans are a lot like us. They're simple, they're easygoing, they're country, and they like a good time. And I just think, we just took some chances with some different sounds.
Sounds that traditional country music lovers originally balked at.
Yeah, it's the same thing they did to become superstars. So, you know what? Music's ever evolving. It's pretty cool to be part of it. And, you know what, we just have influences all over the map, so as songwriters and artists, it's fun to be able to write music that kind of brings all those influences together.
With the lyrics already flowing for their next record, it has these two untraditional country artists fantasizing about future collaborations.
I think for both of us, we'd love to work with Drake, Lil Wayne, Wiz Khalifa. I mean, there's Dr. Dre, who knows, maybe even Will Smith. I mean, the list goes on and on, so. Who knows? I mean, we'll see what happens down the road.
What you can bet on?
Got quite a few songs knocked out, and they're sounding great. And just excited to get new music out. I mean, there's nothing more exciting than, you know, writing it, recording it, taking it out on the road and playing it and seeing how it does on the radio.
It's just kind of got the same FGL feel, you know.
When it comes to staying true to themselves, the name of their record, Here's to the Good Times, says it all.
And we've had fun since we were in my Tahoe. Now we've got a whole bunch of buses out, trailers out. So, I mean, that's the thing, you know. We just love getting to play music, our music, to our amazing fans. It doesn't beat it.
Edmonton has gone country for the second year in a row, playing host to the Canadian Country Music Association Awards at Rexall Place once again. From the first stars who stepped onto the green carpet to the night's biggest winner, here are your highlights.
There were nearly as many umbrellas as there were cowboy hats on the John Deere green carpet at last night's CCMA Awards. But if country stars are anything, it's laid back, not letting even a lot of rain dampen their spirits.
The train of my dress is soaking wet, but that's okay. You can't see that part.
This is perfect because it's a green carpet because of John Deere. Farmers love rain. You know, you need rain to grow anything.
I've not been on a John Deere green carpet before. Pretty pretty cool. I actually have a lot of AstroTurf in my house back in Nashville, so this feels like being at home.
Fans made themselves at home up to 5 hours before the Stars even hit the green carpet, something that did not go unnoticed by two of country music's seasoned veterans.
So I feel so sad for the fans that it's pouring rain for them, but they're there and we appreciate it.
It's awesome. Just everything I sign, it's not working. My Sharpie's dying because everything's wet. So I feel bad that the autograph stuff isn't working out, but I have a hat. This is my umbrella.
There was one Canadian icon in particular who wasn't whining about the weather, but celebrating coming full circle.
I love Edmonton, first of all. I mean, this is where we cut our teeth, and it seemed like when we were starting out in Red Rider, we were here every second week, but CCMA's rock.
And rock is what Tom Cochran, Paul Brandt, George Kanyon, and the Roadhammers did to kick off the 32nd CCMA Awards. And honored with the first award of the night, Lacombe's Gord Bamford.
To be here in Edmonton to win that award, I was lucky enough to win it in Edmonton a few years back, and I always said to myself, I just would like to win that one more time just to validate it, and I didn't expect it, and although I'm going to enjoy it.
He certainly looked like he enjoyed his next big win for Male Artist of the Year. While the score for Bamford knocked out Dean Brody, he wasn't completely excluded from taking home Hardware either.
It feels great. I mean, we took some risks on this record that I maybe wouldn't have on the first record, and I think it's paid off.
Hard work paid off for newcomer Jess Moskaluk, who looked shocked to hear her name called for Female Artist of the Year.
I've grown up listening to Terry Clark, and to be even considered in the same category as her, there's no way I could have ever imagined that I would be standing here with you wonderful people right now.
While only 8 awards were handed out last night, it was clear the priority was to pack one performance.
Some songs need a boss on the stone floor. Couple buckets of beer, whiskey drunk, throwing dollars in a tin jar.
After another.
They all know why we're getting drunk on the plane.
After another into the 2-hour show. And to make plenty of time for hosts comedian legend Rick Mercer and Juno-winning singer Jan Arden.
I've noticed we've had cheap wine and cigarettes, drunk on a plane, day drinking. I'm starting to notice that a lot of these songs are about alcohol.
Our next song is about a farm being torn down.
That's more traditional, yeah.
To build a liquor store!
While they cranked up the controversy, the youngest CCMA winner ever, Alberta's own Brett Kissel, cranked up the charisma, accepting for CMT Video of the Year and closing out the CCMA Awards right here at home.
Without a doubt, I've dreamt of this day all my life, and to win my Canadian Country Music Award right here at Rexall Place for Video of the Year means the world to me.
Never wanted anyone or anything the way I want you, girl. I think over my.
This was our second and final year to host, so in 2015, the CCMA Awards move on to Halifax.